Like I told you earlier, the impeachment of the president of the United States may be a huge story, but it's practically a non-issue as far as the stock market is concerned, because we all kind of know how it's going to play out down there. In other words, it's already baked in. I'm much more concerned with genuinely new developments that can shake things up. Like what we heard from FedEx last night, very disturbing. The shipping company reported a substantial profit, but it was still much lower than expected. They earned $2.51 per share. Analysts were looking for $2.76. That's a bad miss. Then FedEx slashed its full-year forecast from $11 to $13 range, down to $10.25 to $11.50. Hugely disappointing. And that's why the stock got clocked today, plunging more than $16, or 10%. But honestly, given how many things are going wrong for FedEx, it's incredible to me that they're making any money at all. What exactly did they botch? All right, for starters, management completely misjudged the amount of business they do on Cyber Monday. They had 37.8 million packages when they'd only planned for 33 million. Now, you might think having way too much business is a high-quality problem, but not in the shipping industry. It's hard to make money when you're forecasting that poorly. Second, FedEx was banking on an increase in world trade. Now, I don't know where the heck they're getting that kind of wishful thinking, as the trade war with China has really weighed on global commerce. And that's exactly what happened this quarter. Oops. Third, FedEx made a huge acquisition in Europe, buying TNT Express for $4.8 billion back in 2015. TNT is still not integrated well. That's truly suboptimal. And with Brexit on the horizon, you got something else that could put a damper on European commerce. Fourth, they have a very fraught relationship with Amazon, which you could argue used to be their most important client. FedEx has disputes with the online colossus over the cost of freight. And Amazon actually cut them off from third-party shipments a week before Christmas. Wow. The money? That's the money week. I mean, they publicly stated that FedEx is just too, they do it too slowly.
The house of pain.
Grinch alert. Amazon's going from a large client to a vicious competitor that also badmouths them for not doing a good job. Fifth, FedEx added Saturday and Sunday delivery without seeming to realize that delivering on weekends could blow up their budget with unforeseen costs. Oops. Sixth, their fleet of planes is outmoded. Their staff of 490,000 workers is ridiculously bloated. And worst of all, management doesn't even think they can make cuts because it would hurt morale. It's such a mess that even though FedEx disappointed, I'm stunned they made as much money as they did. Now, I don't know how to fix FedEx, the company. That's too hard. I'm not in that game. But I do have some suggestions for how to turn the stock around. First, I would stop doing what CFO Alan Graf did on the call, which was basically predict the bottom when there's no bottom in sight. They need to start being more realistic. Stop calling bottoms. Second, they should stop giving guidance entirely if they can't make an accurate forecast. When you don't know what's happening, when you're overrun by events, it's better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to speak and remove all doubt. Finally, FedEx needs to stop trying to stay highly profitable and instead spend the money they need to be competitive in a world where e-commerce is growing much faster than they ever expected. They need to take that darn hit. And if that means bringing in a new management, so be it. Look, FedEx keeps messing up, but this company is not a disgrace. The real disgrace is that management keeps believing they've got it right, when in reality, they're dead wrong. Stop the predictions, stop the sham guidance, and take the time to figure it all out. Then, and only then, will FedEx the stock be able to bottom. Stick with Cramer.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com. Or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.